this video, I will be talking about how to help kids make better decisions. Now, kids are very smart, kids are very sharp. I really love children and I love interacting with them as a teacher. I see that the most difficult children in my class, when you know how to talk to them, can start getting motivated and start cultivating interest in something that they were clearly refusing to participate in. So in this video, we'll be touching upon how to motivate your children, how to instill in your children that high sense of self-esteem from where they can make their decision with ease and without any guilt. Now, when it comes to decision-making, we can start teaching our kids to start independently making their own decisions from a very early ages. Now, the age I'm going to give you is the age of 3. You can let your child start making his or her own decisions from the age of 3. Why the age of 3? Because psychologically, at the age of 3, the child's ego begins to develop. Now, when the child's ego begins to develop, you will notice that your child wants to have his own cupboard. The child wants to fold his own clothes. So you can start with the simple everyday stuff like helping children to make their choices independently from the age of 3. When you're giving them some dishes which needs the choice making to be done, they have to select one out of 2 or 3 choices. You can always ask your child which one would he or she prefer instead of creating a choice for him or her yourself. That is a usual tendency we do when kids are very young. So you can start creating choices for them, not for food items, but also for clothing items from the books they would like to read. So when you do so, you are giving an opportunity to your child to work on his own brain's network of connections. So you are helping to improve your child's brain's connections by giving him that opportunity to think independently for himself or herself. So that is one thing you can do. Besides that, when it comes to behavior management, and that also we will talk about, then how can you help your child to make independent decisions about their own behavior? Let's say your child is acting difficult and you do not know how to manage your child's behavior. The child is doing something that is not up to your liking and you are stopping the child from doing that action, but all your attempts have been kind of going to waste and you're feeling a helpless and a powerless parent. So it all comes down to how you talk to your children. So instead of resisting what your child had been doing, if you begin to cooperate with your child and start taking interest in the activity that the child is participating in or in any action that child is doing, let's say the child is banging something on the floor and it is irritating you and you don't want your child to bang something like a utensil or a fork or any item on the floor. It is just a specific example I have chosen, but there could be a wide variety of scenarios available. So you want to stop your child, but your child is not listening to you. So in such a case, it's very important that you start taking interest in your child's activity. You go down and sit with your child and you bang it on the floor with him once or twice. Now, you will see when you will do this, your child is going to be so very happy. They are going to look at you with such adoration and admiration that you as a parent are interested in what they are interested in as well. So instead of resisting children's actions, you start showing interest. This is the initial step that you can do, is to take interest in their action. So once you have taken an interest in their action, you have already brought your child's behavior under control. You have created a relationship of trust with your child at this stage. Besides that, when it comes to behavior management, and that also we will talk about, then how can you help your child to make independent decisions about their own behavior? Let's say your child is acting difficult and you do not know how to manage your child's behavior. The child is doing something that is not up to your liking and you are stopping the child from doing that action, but all your attempts have been kind of going waste, and you're feeling a helpless and a powerless parent. So it all comes down to how you talk to your children. So instead of resisting what your child had been doing, if you begin to cooperate with your child and start taking interest in the activity that the child is participating in or in any action that child is doing, let's say the child is banging something on the floor and it is irritating you and you don't want your child to bang something like a utensil or a fork or any item on the floor. It is just a specific example I have chosen, but there could be wide variety of scenarios available. So you want to stop your child, but your child is not listening to you. So in such a case, it's very important that you start taking interest in your child's activity. You go down and sit with your child and you bang it on the floor with him once or twice. Now, you will see when you will do this, your child is going to be so very happy. They are going to look at you with such adoration and admiration that you as a parent are interested in what they are interested in as well. So instead of resisting children's actions, you start showing interest. This is the initial step that you can do, is to take interest in their action. So once you have taken an interest in their action, you have already brought your child's behavior under control. You have created a relationship of trust with your child at this stage. So once your relationship of trust has been created with your child, he is more open to listen to you at this stage.